Okay, hello everyone. We're going to talk about Road to Ember 2.0. This is a new major release. They promised they're going to make it in half a year. They mentioned second quarter of next year, so we'll see if they...
So it's like HTML bars that was released 3 months ago.
We'll see. So, I'm Kenis Migrant from Ukraine. I work in Hovdog. We are some proxy, half Ukrainian, half Dutch company. So I'm gonna find some opportunity to work directly, but we'll see anyway. What is planned for Ember 2.0? Most of the features that are discussed currently, I will show you on the last slide, the link to GitHub where on the page where the ideas are shared and discussed about what's gonna happen in Ember 2.0. So most of all, they talk about template updates, which is HTML bars essentially. So it's gonna be not handlebars anymore, but HTML bars. Components instead of current controller plus template approach. Ember CLI. They already now highly encourage people to migrate to Ember to use Ember CLI because they say that they will change their documentation and examples and other stuff to actually use it to make it as a standard. To avoid, to prevent a situation when all people have their own build tool and make a mess. So this is going to be a single console stuff for everyone. And one of the goals they tend to achieve is the simplification of concepts. We'll see which one do they mean. They try to learn from the competitors. What they want to do is to be a little bit better with backwards compatibility in comparison with Angular. So still it will be not perfect, but until the last edition of Angular of Ember 1, there will be backwards compatibility, and the last version of Ember 1 will have almost all features that will be in Ember 2.0. So with the last transfer from during the last transfer to Ember 2.0, there will be just a normal 6 weeks release. So they will spend this time just to clear all the deprecated stuff that was in Ember 1 but will not be in Ember 2. Like in Angular, they turn to try to use components instead of controllers plus templates. What they found also good in Angular is the dependency injection, which is going to be implemented in Ember 2.0, we'll see. Like in React, the killer feature of React is a virtual DOM. Yeah, it's when you want to update at least something, re-render it. They just ask to render everything, and with the help of virtual DOM, they just compare what's gonna be re-rendered and what they just compare old version of DOM and the new one, and they just change only the things that gonna be changed, nothing odd. So regarding simplifying Ember concept, these are the main stuff they gonna do, and on the further slides we will touch upon most of these issues. Most of the stuff is HTML bars related. So let's take a look on some of them. Intuitive attribute bindings. Currently, this bind attribute is not much intuitive. You should know it in advance how does it work. And if we check the Angular, they already have something similar to this stuff. This improvement in Ember framework will be available starting from the next version, 1.10, so we're gonna be quite soon. Hopefully we're gonna start using it already in the next version. Similar things with components. Currently, we are not able, we are not allowed to use these curly brackets for the source, because otherwise, because if you try to do it, there will be like nested curly breaks and it's not gonna work. But for Ember 1.11, they will make possible these components syntax, like HTML kind of syntax, which will allow to make these curly brackets stuff working. What's next is block parameters issues. Currently, that's what we have nowadays, and you know, we have two ways to iterate. It's like with the help of helpers each and with. And in Ember 2.0, there will be only one recommended, and it will be done like this. So each items as actual item. Why is it better? We'll see on this slide. Previously, when we are already in the middle of each scope, we have no access to the author, so we know some. We know properties of a given item, but we cannot get access to the, for example, the something related to the all collection, to the all items. So in future there will be this approach, with the help of which we will, in the very middle, we will have access both to the item properties and items, which is sometimes good. What else? By default, they say they're gonna be only one-way binding. Since they noticed that you are not always in need of two-way bindings, by default there will be only one-way, which will probably improve performance. So by default in Ember 2.0, bar cannot be changed by the component in this case. And if you really want to have two-way bindings, you can allow it by putting the mute, which makes mutable, which means mutable, so that it could be done two ways. It could be changed both ways. Separated component parameters. There is currently a good practice for experienced developers dealing with components. Inside of the component, they use this way to declare the properties. Some of them are just for internal usage, and some of them could be accessed from outer, and they divide it in such two sections. What gonna happen in Ember 2.0 is that all the public properties will be accessible inside of this outer's hash map. So if you would like to use it, you could just make this dot address dot src or post dot title. So there will be less mess. Routable components, that's what they wanted to do in order to switch to components. So previously, currently, when a route is entered, it's always deals with controller and the model which is it associated to, and then it's just passed to the view for rendering. Next, there will be a component as a first class stuff, for which route there will be rendered complete component. And the model for it will be passed through the attribute. So next is dealing with actions. If now we have on some parent component, we have like in case of some key is pressed, we just send an action related to it from the child component with this syntax. And in future, you have more flexibility. You can use the syntax like action, and then which actual method will be used in parent component for that, for such stuff. And you can call it, as it was mentioned before, just with these attributes cache, and it's gonna work. We'll see. So, as I promised on the last slide, I show you the link to the GitHub page where they really discuss it quite thoroughly. You can participate and share your thoughts. While waiting for the current Ember meetup in Amsterdam, I was looking on other meetups, and they say that in New York and Boston there are really useful meetups, and they published their speeches on YouTube. So I really recommend you, if you are interested, to visit these channels. There are really interesting stuff discussed. So it looks that's it. We'll see how it's gonna work in reality, hopefully in half a year or later. Thank you.